Welcome back to the show. Are you used to a live audience like this?
No.
No.
I only have it when I'm with you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, but now you're hosting Saturday Night Live.
I know.
With Kacey Musgraves. It's going to be great.
It's crazy.
Yes. Are you excited? Are you nervous?
I am so nervous. Like, just talking about it, I'm shaking.
Really?
Yes.
No, you're going to be fine. It's going to be great.
Thank you.
Well, you've had, it's Tuesday, right? So you've had a couple meetings so far.
We have had a few.
Yeah. Trust everyone. It's a great cast, great writers. You're going to crush it.
We went through a blast. I felt yesterday, it was like walking into camp.
Yeah. No, they all want to take care of you, and that's really, they all want a great show. And then when you're done with the show, because you do a dress rehearsal, you're done with the show, you feel like you want to do it again. You're like, let's do it one more time, guys. I know it's 1 a.m, but let's go. Let's do it one. We have all the costumes. Let's do it. Yeah. You're going to crush it.
Thank you.
Last time you were here, we were talking about your rom-com, Anyone But You, and Glenn. Congratulations. It is a massive hit. It keeps breaking records.
I know.
People love the rom-com. You brought it back.
Thank you.
You crushed it.
I'm just so thankful that everybody's loving it.
Yeah. I think we want it. We need it. We feel like a little laughter, a little love.
A little love, a little romance.
Two good-looking people getting together. Why not? Do you go to the theater when your movie comes out? Do you sneak in with a hat on and be like, hey?
I did, especially. So I was filming in Australia while this has been in theaters. And Joe, who plays Bo, he and I would sneak into theaters and surprise people.
And did they freak out?
No, at first they didn't know what was going on. They were like, what?
So like, what's going on?
Yeah, everyone was dead silent. We're standing up in the front with a microphone. We're like, this is not working.
Well, you think fans are hoping for a sequel. Do you think that maybe we'll see a sequel?
Maybe like a high 9 chance.
Ooh, really? You work? Oh! That's what I'm talking about. All right, I can't wait to see it. And you got to bring us the bloopers next time.
I will.
That was the greatest thing. I don't know if you guys saw it last time Sydney was on. You brought us a blooper where you actually got bit by an actual spider.
I did. I got bit by something else last time. I get bit by everything in Australia.
Yeah. But Glenn thought you were just acting, which just thought was hilarious. Because they were like, you just kept rolling. You're like, And they're like,
I was screaming in pain.
I'm laughing only because you're fine.
At least that we know of.
Yeah, I think you're all right. Yeah, maybe you have spider powers. Who knows? You ever acting since you were a kid? And I was looking through your IMDb page and looking at all the stuff that you've done. Mm-hmm. I do my research. And I saw one down here I want to ask you about. ZMD, Zombies of Mass Destruction. No, that is such a lie. You've never heard of that film, sir.
I hope no one has heard.
Someone is really clapping. He's like, yeah, absolutely! ZMD! 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 Zombies of Mass Destruction! Zombies of Mass Destruction!
You guys, I've never seen this movie! I was in it, but I wasn't allowed to watch it.
You weren't because you were too little?
I was like, I think 11 when I filmed it, 10 or 11.
Yeah. And you got to come back as a zombie. Look at how cute Sydney Sweeney and ZMD.
Aww.
What?
I was so excited.
Right? That's got to be like Halloween, right?
I thought this was the coolest thing ever.
Yeah. And you're like, this is going to, I mean, you're going to end up with a giant movie career.
Yeah.
Just from ZMD.
One arm.
Zombies of Mass Destruction. We actually have a clip from the movie.
Oh, no. I don't know if I've ever seen this.
I don't think the movie ever thought it would air on The Tonight Show, but here it is.
It's ever gone.
Here it is. ZMD, Zombies of Mass Destruction, Sydney Sweeney.
Lisa, everything's going to be okay, all right? Nothing bad is going to happen to you. I promise, okay? Okay, let's go.
That's an unbelievable scene.
Oh my God.
That's an unbelievable scene.
I'm never gonna see the end of this on Twitter.
Did this inspire you to produce this new horror movie that you're in now, Immaculate?
I never could get it out of my mind.
No, you can't get that. You can't unsee that, no.
No, my dad loves horror films.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, and so I grew up watching them with him, and I always wanted to do something in that genre. And I auditioned for a version of this movie when I was 16.
Really?
Yeah.
And they
never made it.
So you had this in your brain.
Whatever
happened to Immaculate?
Yeah, and so 10 years later, I decided to make it.
How do you do that? Do you call like an agent or something?
Yeah, I called my agents, and I said, I can't get this script out of my mind. What's happened with it? It went in a turnaround somewhere, and...
Good for you.
I contacted the writer, and we rewrote it to match me as a 25-year-old.
Yeah.
And then I attached producers to it. I took it to a financier. And
you really
I hired
hard.
Director. Yeah, I produced. It was my first thing I ever produced. It was amazing.
Congratulations.
Thank you. What's really, really crazy is I wrapped that movie on a Friday, and then on Monday I was filming Anyone But You.
No way.
Yeah.
So you're going from a scary movie to the most fun, friendly movie ever. Yeah. How do we describe Immaculate? It's a horror movie.
Yeah, it's like a psychological horror film.
Yeah. And who do you play in this?
I play Cecilia.
Yes.
I'm a nun.
You play a nun.
I play a nun.
Yes.
It makes a lot of sense.
I think perfect. I think it's perfect. And you actually filmed this in Italy.
In Italy, yeah. So she gets sent to a very obscure convent outside of Rome. And some crazy starts to happen to her.
Yeah. You brought some of your family members along with you.
I did. I flew my grandmas out.
Come on.
I know.
Who's nicer than you?
They'd never been to Europe. My grandie's dream was to go to Italy. She's never left the country before. And so I surprised them, flew them there, and I let them be extras in the movie. They were like little old nuns in there.
Yeah, so their grandmas are nuns in the movie, and then I have a picture. I go, do you have a picture of your grandma? You sent me a bunch.
I did.
This one stuck out. Is grandma getting a smoke break in between
Yes.
I just thought that was real. I just thought that was a real picture. It's like, all right.
This is my grandie. She's iconic. And she needed a smoke break in between takes.
Yeah.
So we went outside and I had to capture how amazing she looked.
Yeah. In the film, your character is pregnant, which meant that you have to wear a fake belly for a lot of it.
Yes.
Was that hard to act with that?
You know, I actually really enjoyed it.
You did?
I did because I found out it's a great place to put snacks.
You were hiding things in your...
Put snacks in my belly.
What? What snacks would you put in your belly?
I had Sour Patch Kids.
I love that.
Yeah, just a little snack.
Yeah, every now and then you just reach in.
They're like, what are you doing?
I just have snacks in my belly.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta keep it light. I wanna show everyone a clip. Here's Sydney Sweeney in Immaculate. Take a look at this.
I'm sorry for these. Remnants. Hello?
Sydney Sweeney, everybody, Immaculate, is in theaters March 22nd. She is hosting Saturday Night Live this weekend. We'll be right back with Joe Manganiello. Stick around. Hey, hey.